Hi, I'm Tony Anscombe, and welcome to this special edition of We Live Security Cybersecurity News. Now, phishing, vishing, smishing, and farming are some of the most prevalent cybersecurity issues reported to the Federal Bureau of Investigation's Internet Crime Unit. Both consumers and businesses are attacked frequently by the deluge of attempts made by bad actors to defraud us of our identity, our credentials, our money, and anything else we have that they deem may be of value. Now, recently, my esteemed colleagues at ESEC Canada decided to host a phishing derby to see if entrants could spot the difference between fake and real emails and text messages, all under the pressure of a timed challenge. So how well would you do? Well, let's play the game. Here is question one. A message from the Government of Canada informing that a COVID alert contact tracing app is available. You have 15 seconds to decide if the message is real or fake. Now, some of these are harder than others. So this message is real. Note that there is no link and the action is to independently visit the legitimate app store. So here comes question two. An email notification from Vibe Play, letting you know that your subscription renewal has failed. Yep, it's fake. Note the grammatical errors and the generic dressing in the email. Now, question three, an email from a work colleague regarding your budget work. It's fake. The sender's email address should be enough to set off the alarm bells. Always check the sender is legitimate. Question four, another text message question. A PBC alert informing you that your client card has been disabled. This one is also fake. Banks don't send you messages or emails directing you to log in. Always use the official banking app or type the bank's address into your browser and log in that way. And finally, here is question five. An email from PBC Bank about the encryption used in email systems and that you may need to upgrade. Now this one's a little tougher. It looks real. The sender, format, the grammar is okay. That's because it is real. But my instinct would be not to trust this. I would log in and see if the message is also in my account inbox. So how did you do? In the actual quiz, entrants were shown three examples from a possible nine. Now, I've only shared five of those with you here. Now, in the quiz, 68% failed to identify all three correctly. So don't feel too bad if you failed to identify them all. Now, for more news, come and check out welivesecurity.com. Stay safe, stay healthy, and I look forward to seeing you next week.